There, the radio is ready to be used.
Superb, mademoiselle. You do not need to learn the Morse code if you have the book as reference.
That will save the cell from draining while I'm not using it. There, the radio is ready to be used.
Thank you.
That will save the cell from draining while I'm not using it. There, the radio is ready to be used. That will save the cell from draining while I'm not using it.
Well, had a good rummage through my kit, I expect?
Yes, thank you. There is still some information I think you might be able to give us.
Indeed? I hardly think so.
Is that pipe cleaner one of yours?
Don't know. I don't have them monogrammed.
Can you tell me how the pipe cleaner came to be in Monsieur Ratchet's compartment?
Haven't a clue.
Did you go into Monsieur Ratchet's compartment at any time?
I've never even spoken to the man.
You never spoke to him, and you did not murder him.
If I had, I should hardly be likely to acquaint you with the fact.
Ah, well, it is of no consequence.
Oh?
Monsieur Poirot has told me he can think of 11 excellent explanations of its presence. Not now, when it's all over, when it's behind us.
Is that a quote?
Mademoiselle Debenham said those words to you at Sakeki Station in Istanbul. Tell me to what those words referred.
Why don't you ask Miss Debenham?
I will.
You have nothing whatever against her.
I'm sorry, but you're wrong. We know that Mademoiselle Debenham was governess in the Armstrong household at the time Daisy Armstrong was kidnapped.
The devil, you say?
If Mademoiselle Debenham is innocent, why did she conceal the fact?
I have no idea, but your suspicions are utter rot.
Why did Mademoiselle Debenham tell me she had never been to America?
You better ask her. I still think you are wrong. You're making a serious mistake.
I think it is you, Colonel, who have made the mistake.
Hello again.
Monsieur McQueen.
I love how you say my name.
Will you be serious?
I am serious. Sorry. I'd better be careful. I've realized I'm definitely the most suspicious character on the train. All you have to do is find a will in which the old man left me all his money, and that'll just about clinch it.
Is there a will?
Not that I know of. He'd never leave me a cent, really. I was just useful to him. Languages and so on. I'm no linguist, but I can get by in German and Italian and French.
You told me you knew Sonia Armstrong.
Yes, I did. My dad was the district attorney on the case. So yes, well, I was just a kid, of course, a teenager. Schoolboy crush, I suppose, and all that.
It occurs to me that in spite of everything, the murder may not have to do with the Armstrong case at all.
Oh? I thought that must be pretty settled.
We have much evidence pointing to the existence of an outsider aboard the train. One who disguises himself, uses a stiletto to kill, then vanishes into the snow. What do you think?
It's certainly a possibility, but in that case, it'll be hard to catch now. He's had quite a head start.
Or he could be out there frozen in a snowdrift or lying broken at the bottom of a rocky ravine. The body may never be found until the spring thaw.
Well, that conjures up an unpleasantly graphic image. You seem to really enjoy this stuff.
I enjoy the investigation, monsieur. I certainly do not enjoy the fact that a man has died.
No, of course not. Say, I was just wondering. I mean, I have no plans to return to the States right away. I may find myself back in Istanbul. I was wondering if you might consider having dinner with me some night.
I might consider it if you promise to relax.
Relax? Sure, you bet! You will? Say, that's swell!